In today's video, I'm going to show you how to configure Ubuntu PRoot with GNOME Desktop. Personally, I still prefer Debian with GNOME as it has less problems with some packages since it doesn't depend on Snapped, but I will show you the complete process with Ubuntu. As always, I leave the process written in my GitHub repository. Inside the repository, we go to the Ubuntu PRoot section to the first steps part. Copy the first command directly into Termix and wait for the packages to install. We return to the repository and we continue with the installation, now of the Ubuntu environment with the tool PRoot distro. When it finishes, it will log us directly in Ubuntu and we will be able to check it since it will appear root at localhost. Once inside, we will update the repositories and install a few packages to check that everything is okay. After finishing the process, we are going to go to the section on how to install graphical desktops on the Ubuntu we just downloaded. Before we start, we are going to create a new user with the command you see on the screen. In my case, it will be called DroidMaster. Set the password by typing it twice when prompted, and then give the user root permissions to be able to run any command. To give the superuser permissions, we are going to edit the sudoers file with the command that you see on the screen. We look for the line where it says root, and we add an equal one for the user that we have just created. Now we change to the user we have created with the command you see. To check that everything is okay, we use the huami command with and without sudo. We leave the PRoot environment completely and start the installation of GNOME. Copy the first command from the repository to log into Ubuntu with the user we have recently created. Install the necessary packages containing GNOME and all its dependencies. Then we copy and execute the following command to fix a bug that does not allow GNOME to run even though we have installed it. After finishing, we only have to disable Snapped, the new way that Ubuntu has to install packages, but unfortunately it is not compatible with our Android. This is the main reason why I recommend Debian instead of Ubuntu. In the video description, you have several videos about Debian and how to install GNOME on it. We also install a web browser like Firefox. Now we just need to run the script to launch Ubuntu with GNOME directly. To do this, we go to the download script section and copy the command that will download it automatically. Once downloaded, we give it execution permissions and we can run it. In my case, to execute, it gave me problems. If it happens to you, we simply have to run again the command that I mentioned above that fixes some problems that GNOME has to launch, but this time we will do it with the root user. To log in with root, we just have to run the command that I show you. And once inside, copy and paste again the command that we have used previously. We try to launch the script again, and now we should be able to see our Ubuntu with GNOME. Don't worry that the first time a blue screen background appears, but it can be changed. Now we have all the tools that GNOME brings by default, and we can use it without any problem. In my case, I will start changing the wallpaper by downloading one from the internet, for example, the original Ubuntu wallpaper. Apart from this, I also recommend you to install some tools that allow you to configure GNOME. The problem is that most of the plugins that I have tested do not work properly, but I leave the process of how to do it in case you want to try it in Debian because they're if they work better. Another bug I found is that the settings application does not launch. We only have available the tweaks application to configure the appearance. I hope you liked it since you have asked me for it a lot. I still recommend Debian instead of Ubuntu because of compatibility issues, but it never hurts to try new things. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.